Like I say, respect it when the other guy's getting it done.
I don't know.
This contest, 4-12. Phillies are 5-9. Montreal went 1-5 in Puerto Rico. The Expos have scored only 26 runs in 16 games. One game in the NHL.
Summer nights. It's a first glimpse at the summer stars that will swing their way into the city's sports consciousness. A time when stars are born and moments are remembered. It's the Montreal Expos home opener next on The Score. Constructed in 1976 for the Olympics. In 1977, it became the home of the Montreal Expos. And for the 28th year out of the 36-year history, the Expos will have their home opener tonight against the Philadelphia Phillies. Hello, everybody. I'm Sam Cosentino, along with a guy who got a chance to play in some of those openers, Mr. Darren Fletcher. And Fletch, it's always a special night with the home opener.
It's awesome. I mean, you got, where else as a player where they turn the lights out, they got the spotlight on you coming out to take the starting lineup. It's a great time to be a big leaguer.
Well, let's get you down to the field for the starting lineup for today's game in the Montreal Expos.
Deuxième frappeur fut choisi joueur de l'année pour une deuxième fois en trois saisons. Il détient le record pour le plus grand nombre de circuits par un joueur d'arrêt court et a remporté un grand or pour sa défensive. Batting second has been selected the Expos' most valuable player two of the last three seasons. D'arrêt court, shortstop, le numéro 18, number 18, Orlando Cabrera. Meilleur joueur de deuxième but des Ligues majeures. Il a participé à son troisième match des étoiles l'an dernier. Batting third, best second baseman in baseball. He played in his third All-Star game last year. Accueillons le deuxième but, second baseman, le numéro 3, number 3, José Vidro. L'une des nouvelles acquisitions des Expos cette année, il a participé au match des étoiles à deux reprises. Il a frappé 57 circuits lors des deux dernières saisons. Batting fourth, one of the Expos' new additions this season, he is a two-time All-Star. Le troisième but, third baseman, le numéro 7, number 7, Tony Batista. Le cinquième frappeur veut être montant au baseball. Il a prouvé qu'il est un joueur talentueux, polyvalent. Atteint son en carrière la saison dernière en produisant 77 points. Batting fifth, the rising star in baseball. He drove in a career high 77 runs last year. Le voltigeur de centre, center fielder. Le numéro 6, number 6, Brad Wilkerson.
Thank you.
sélectionné joueur de l'année des ligues mineures l'an dernier. Il a frappé pour une moyenne de 324. Batting seventh, the Expos Minor League Player of the Year in 2003. He batted for 324 with 22 home runs. Le joueur de premier but, first baseman de numéro 48, number 48, Termell Sledge. Le receveur catcher, le numéro 23, number 23, Brian Schneider. Batting ninth and pitching tonight for the Expos. He was one of the most impressive rookie pitchers in the league last year. He made 20 starts in 2003. Le numéro 33, number 33, warming up in the clubhouse, Claudio Vargas.
Been called the best home opener in all of baseball Survivor Series. Here's hoping the Expos offense will catch fire. When we're back, we'll set you up. And Darren Fletcher with you. And you know, last year the Expos embarked on a 25-day, 22-game trip, which saw them go from six cities to the south, to the west, back to the east, essentially putting them out of the playoff race. Well, this year it hasn't started any better. Florida for three, Puerto Rico for six, Philly for three, New York for four games, and here we are in Montreal for a three-game set before the Expos will embark on a seven-game West Coast swing. That begins Monday in San Diego. And part of the process and all that travel, well, the hitters seem to be struggling, having gone through all this travel. One of those guys, Tony Bautista.
Well, you know what? Tony's a guy that is a streaky hitter, and I think that he can amass big numbers in a short period of time. So I'm not giving up on Tony. I think he's going to be able to swing the bat for this team.
He'll be in charge as one of those guys look to fill the void and up the numbers, as you saw there, ranked last in every offensive category. Another guy that the Expos will lean on to help fill that void is Jose Vidro, a 300 hitter over the last five seasons.
Yeah, Sam, career 306 hitter. This guy's a three-time All-Star. I think the best, purest hitter the Montreal Expos have in their lineup.
Well, you talked a little bit about Tony Bautista, but the other big two guys in the lineup that combined the big three are Orlando Cabrera, two homers, five RBIs, Jose Vidro with the seven RBIs. That leads the team. The average is not so bad. They'd like to see both guys really up those numbers quite a bit, but it's been tough. The table has not been set. We got a chance to catch up with manager Frank Robinson before the game and ask him about his team's hitting woes in the early part of the season.
Well, it's tough because we felt very good about the club that we had and selected to start the season here. We had a very good spring training, and we felt like we were get off to a good start and be a factor in this pennant race throughout the season, and wouldn't have to be playing catch-up as we are going to have to do now. But that's the way it is. But it's a long season, and we have time to dig ourselves out of this hole.
Well, it's been well documented that the hitting has not been so good in the early part of the season, but Frank Robinson really has to be happy with his pitching staff so far.
The Expos are one of only a small handful of teams that have an ERA under 4. Montreal is also amongst the league leaders in fewest walks and hits allowed. That's outstanding considering the entire staff, except for Joey Eichen, who remains on the DL, is 29 years of age or younger. The starting staff in particular has been great, even though 3 of the 5 hurlers entered the season with 25 or less career starts. Levon Hernandez, who recently signed a 3-year contract extension, heads the rotation. He's 1-2 with a 3.04. With over 200 career starts, the 6'2" righty is easily the leader of this group. 3 other starters, Claudio Vargas, Zach Day, and John Patterson, had just 58 starts between them heading into the 2004 season. Teamed with Toma Oka, the Montreal pitching staff was supposed to be just adequate. But so far, through the first 16 games of the season, they're proving people wrong, although their performances have not translated into a boatload of wins. As good as the starters have been, the bullpen has been that much better. Supposedly the weakest link of the Expos, the relief corps is made up of a mishmash bunch that has just flat-out performed. Anchored by Rocky Biddle, acquired in a deal with the White Sox, he had 1 career save before exploding for 34 in 2003. The Expos have a legitimate closer on their hands. Chad Cordero was Montreal's number one pick in the 2003 draft and became the first Expo to make the jump to the big leagues in the same year he was drafted. Chad Vance is another Expo draftee and rookie. He was selected in the 2001 draft. Luis Ayala spent 5 years in the Mexican League before perfecting his craft with the Expos in 2003. Jeremy Fikoch was acquired from the A's for, of all things, cash. Sunwoo Kim spent most of his time in the Boston farm system before landing in Montreal. Remarkably, as a staff, the Expos bullpen has kept opposing hitters to below 300 average. So, with continued success, the W's aren't far from adding up.
The opposition tonight, the Philadelphia Phillies, and after 2 years ago making a big free agent splash by signing Jim Thome, they thought they had the final piece of the puzzle by getting Billy Wagner this year, but getting back to Thome, a guy who's really struggled in April, he has really picked it up this April.
He has. You know, the last couple Aprils, he hasn't been swinging the bat as well. Larry Boas said he's moved his hands in a little bit, tightened up his swing some, and he's having some pretty good production thus far.
Another guy in the middle of that Phillies lineup is Pat Burrell, who 2 years ago drove in 116 runs while batting .286. Those numbers dipped dramatically last year as he hit just .209 while driving in 64, but he's on fire to start the year.
Well, Burrell's back, and they need him back. The Phillies are going to live and die with the home run, and I think Pat Burrell needs to hit the taters for this Phillies team to win.
It's the Phillies and the Expos. When we come back, we're just minutes away from the first pitch. You're watching Montreal Expos Baseball on the Score Television Network. Ready for the first pitch here. A couple of ceremonies to take care of, as well as some house cleaning, as is always the case on opening day. And we got a chance, Darren, to talk about how exciting the home opener is. Any special memories on your part?
Well, I think back to my first one in 1992 when I made the club out of spring training. It was my first. Obviously, the first is always something special, you know, big crowd. But it was Gary Carter's last. And the standing O that he got when he came out on the field was tremendous. And, you know, just kind of really provided that impetus to try to be a better ball player, you know, and make a difference.
It was the changing of the guard, so to speak, because from there on you took over mostly as the everyday catcher and had several good years here as a Montreal Expo. If we take you back to 1969, Jerry Park, the first year the Montreal Expos were in existence. And there's the scene there. Boy, I tell you what, the ballparks have come a long way since Jerry Park. But two teams were initiated into the National League. It was the Montreal Expos and the San Diego Padres both made it into the league in that time. The St. Louis Cardinals were the opponent on that day, and just a couple of days later, light hitting shortstop Dal Maxel hit an inside the park grand slam. It was the first ever home run outside of the United States in Major League Baseball, and boy, a lot of people remember that. And Jerry Park, a lot of fond memories of that place as well for a lot of people. I know when you came here, a lot of people must have talked about that.
Yeah, they talked about Jerry Park. what I noticed about that clip, it was Rusty Staub running around the bases, and he had didn't have any sleeves on.
LeGrand LaRange. We're going to get you down to the field now. Jose Vidra won the Silver Slugger Award given annually to the top player hitting-wise in their position. Vidra run it for all second basemen last year, and they will honor him here today, and the fans on their feet for Jose Vidra.
Messieurs les invités, maintenant Monsieur Richard Desjardins, représentant de Louisville Slugger, et Omar Minaya, directeur général des Expos, lui présenter le bâton d'argent. Here to present him with the Silver Slugger Award for 2003, please welcome Louisville Slugger representative Richard Desjardins and Expos general manager Omar Minaya. Felicitations, Jose. Congratulations, Jose.
310, 1565, the numbers for Jose Vidra last year, the fifth straight year in which he hit over 300. And here's a guy who does it from both sides of the plate. His numbers very equal from the left and from the right.
Swings the bat well, Sam. You know what's impressive to me, though, is this guy's been here for 7 years. You know, back in 97, he started, and it's 2004. With the big turnover that you normally have in Montreal, you guys kind of come and go. Vidro's been a guy that has stayed here in Montreal, has enjoyed it, and he deserves all the accolades that he gets. He's a great hitter.
And the fans here are making a lot of noise for Vidro, and he, too, in turn, applauding the fans here at the Big O, who have really come out on a night when hockey seems to have taken precedence with the Montreal Canadiens playing game one in Tampa Bay against the top-ranked Eastern Conference team, the Tampa Bay Lightning. But I tell you what, those who are here make a lot of noise, and they make it throughout the game, as you will hear all game long as we get set for this game against the Phillies. Again, a little bit of house cleaning still to take care of with Jose Vidra winning that Silver Slugger Award. That's an award that the players, in my mind, take very seriously.
Yeah, they do. I mean, it's voted on by the writers as the best hitter at your position, and it's a big award. You know, it's a huge award, and Vidra deserves it. You know, he's going to have to carry more of the load, though, this year. You know, with Vladdy gone, Vidra's going to have to continue to hit the ball, and hopefully these Expos can win some ball games.
Another one of the ceremonies we're talking about, Roger Brulot will throw the ceremonial first pitch. A broadcaster here in Montreal for years will enter the Expos Hall of Fame this year. Ron Pichet is out there right now, a longtime employee.